Mic test, mic test. Hello guys, I'm Ritvik Dashora and I'm back with a new video and some new learnings. Everyone is confused about which Python package is the best for technical analysis. And there are many out there in the market, but the one that I'm going to talk about in this video is the best, TA-Lib. And you know what guys, I used the same library in my last video as well, in which I created a Bitcoin trading bot. And guys, it generated some excess return over Bitcoin, and the Sharpe ratio was higher than Bitcoin. You can click on this I button to learn how I used TA-Lib library in that video and how I created the Bitcoin trading bot step by step. Let's come back to TA-Lib. TA-Lib stands for Technical Analysis Library, and it incorporates more than 200 technical indicators. The only annoying thing is that sometimes it becomes very difficult to install and use this library. In this video, I will solve all your doubts. Watch this video till the end, and I'm going to talk about not just installation, but also something that no one knows about in TA-Lib library. So before we get into that, if you're new around here, on this channel, I turn you into a successful financial programmer. Here I upload videos on trending things such as trading bots, implementation of AI in finance, some free finance APIs and how to use them, and explanation of important libraries like this one, TA-Lib, etc, etc. So that's something you're interested in, then smash the subscribe button and hit on the bell icon. Also, I offer an amazing gift to all my lovely subscribers. I'll tell you in this video. Today we will talk about how to install TA-Lib in different platforms, how to use function API in TA-Lib, how to use abstract API in TA-Lib that no one knows about it, and then I'll show you my user-friendly code that you can use as your starting point for your code, and then I'll tell you what is the gift to all my subscribers. The installation of TA-Lib in Python is difficult because it is not a standard Python package. However, thankfully we have a Python wrapper for TA-Lib, and this is the documentation for the Python wrapper. I have mentioned the link of this website in the description box, and then also I found this amazing article on how to install TA-Lib in Python. I will refer this article to show you how I will be installing TA-Lib in my system, and you can also refer to this article. The link is in the description box. Guys, I use Anaconda for Python, and especially I like the Jupyter Lab or Jupyter Notebook for writing the code, and you can download Anaconda through this website, anaconda.com. And then after installing Anaconda, what you do is write Anaconda here in the start menu, and then write conda update Python here, and then press enter. It will take a lot of time to update everything inside Anaconda platform for Python, and it's better to be updated for everything in Python. Then after that, check your system type, which is Windows architecture. In my case, it's 64-bit operating system, so just keep this thing in mind, because we'll be downloading that particular relevant file for this. Now on the Anaconda prompt, just write Python hyphen hyphen version and then enter, and then see what's the version of your Python. It should be 3.7 or 3.8 in your case. Now come to this website, the link is in the description box, and see, you can see that in TA-Lib there are different wheel files that are available for this, and we just need to do here is see, in my case it was 3.7 point something, the version, Python version, and I have 64-bit operating system. So I'll click this, and this will download a file to my system. Now what we need to do is simple. We just need to copy this file and then save it exactly on this location, which is C users HP. So yes, I have saved this file on exactly in this location, which is C users HP. Copy the name of this file and then come to the Anaconda prompt and just write pip install control V dot whl, don't forget dot whl, this is a representation of wheel file. Enter, and then this will take some time to install the library in your platform. In my case, it's already installed, so you can see in your case it will be installing a lot of, it will be downloading a lot of files. Let's see if it's installed or not. This is my Jupyter Lab platform in Anaconda. I'll just write import TA-Lib and then run this cell. You can see that there's no error. So yeah, this library is now installed. For Mac users, as I don't have a Mac, I use Windows. We can refer this article. In this, it's mentioned that after installing Anaconda, you just need to do brew install TA-Lib and then pip install TA-Lib. It's very easy in Mac. Now, how to install Talib in Google Colab? I got a very good link here, which is this one. Actually, I just copied and pasted this one in Google Colab, and it installed Talib in that. So I actually mentioned this link as well in the description box. So let me just copy this and then come to Google Colab and then paste it and then run it. It will take some time to install, but eventually you'll see after 30 seconds or so, it will install this library. Meanwhile, when it's installing, let's see how many technical indicators are available. So this is a link of programcreek.com, and these many technical indicators are available for Talib. The link is again in the description box, but we can see that if we click any one of these, there's a very good explanation of each and everything. So it's a very good referral point for all of us to see how to use it in our code. Perfect. I think it's installed now. Let's see, import Talib. It should not give me any error. Yeah, it is not. So the Talib is now successfully installed. You can also check about the description of different technical indicators by just writing question mark Talib dot and then any technical indicator you're interested in. For example, Arun. And then if you run this cell, you'll see a doc string on the right hand side, and then it shows what are the types of the inputs that are required and what type of outputs it will give you. To extract all the available functions in Talib, what you can do is just write dir and then Talib, and then this will throw you all the functions that are available inside Talib. Sorry, this will give you the entire directory. And for functions, what you need to do here is talib.get functions and then run this cell. So yeah, I'll have to provide the parentheses as well. If you run this cell, you will get all the functions which are available in Talib library. If you are interested to know what are the function what are the functions which represent any particular type of function groups, then what you need to do here is get function groups. This will give you all the functions which are actually separated with different types of function groups, such as cycle indicators, math operators, math transform, momentum indicators, etc. So after this, what you can do is basically just write, for example, this one. I'm only interested in momentum indicators. So just write momentum indicators in square brackets, and you'll see that all the momentum indicators are in front of you. And we can see that how many function groups are available for Talib. So Talib dot get function groups and then dot keys. And inside this, let's just have a list of everything. So let's see. So these are all the types of function groups which are available in Talib. And you can see that things like pattern recognition, price transform, volatility indicators, each and everything is available here. Can we use all the indicators for our trading bot? Yes, we can. And very soon I'll be uploading a video where I'll be using many technical indicators from the same library. And this video is just focused on how to use Talib. In the next videos, I'll be using Talib directly and referring to this video, such that you don't have any confusion about that. And yes, I'll be using all this I can use all this technical indicators in my trading bot to get something amazing. And you know what? I'm interested to see the pattern recognition. So let's see, if I go inside this and just paste this pattern recognition here, you can see that there are many pattern recognition indicators available, like CDL doji. CDL refers to candlestick, and then doji pattern, evening star, hammer, and all these things which are available, engulfing, etc. Now, before writing the code on how to use Talib on the real-time data of any particular stock, I'm very much interested to know your opinion. Which technical indicator you think is the best for trading purposes? I will feature a few of you in the upcoming videos, and I'm very much interested to know my target audience opinion on different types of technical indicators. So please mention, please. So let's see how to use a Talib library. Import Talib, and then I'm importing Y Finance as YF. Now, what is Y Finance? Y Finance is a library which is available in order to extract pricing data of any particular stock. If you remember, a few months back, there was a library called Pandas Data Raider, which was used in order to extract the pricing details. Now that library doesn't exist anymore, so we are using Y Finance here. Perfect. So let me run this. Okay, I got an error. I'll have to install Y Finance as well. So pip install Y Finance, and then it is installed now. Let's see if it runs. Yeah, perfect. Now let me just write data is equal to yf dot download, and then the ticker, let me just write Tesla, and then start is equal to 2020-01-01, and then end is equal to 2020-03, and today is 18th March, so 18. I think it's better to do it 2019. Done. Now let's see what is the data. It is pandas data frame where we have open, high, close, low, adjusted close and volume. It's very similar to what we got, what we used to get when we used pandas data reader library to extract the pricing details. So yeah, perfect. Now let's use the talib array, talib dot I'm interested, say CDL. All right, let's see Arun indicator. If you remember, I used Arun oscillator in my last video to make the Bitcoin trading bot, so I'll use the same here, Arun oscillator. And in the brackets I can see that I need to provide high low time period, and then it will give me an output. Okay, perfect. So I need to provide high, low and a time period. So for high, I just need to write data and then inside this high. For low, data and then low, and then time period is equal to say 14. Perfect. I got a series where the first few are NaN because the time period is 14. The first 14 rows are NaN. Then after that I have got all these things. If you remember, in my last video as well, I mentioned that the minus 100 means that it is having a downward trend. A plus 100 refers to a uptrend. Let me just provide it here. Let me provide a name here. A rune is equal to this, and then run. And similarly, we can get the pattern recognition as well, which is actually very useful. As I mentioned, all these are pattern recognition. And in this, if I'm interested in something, say engulfing, right? So let me just go here and write engulfing is equal to talib dot cdl engulfing. And then inside this, what I need to provide is open, high, low, close. That's it, right? So by the way, I'm going to tell you what is abstract API, because in abstract API we don't need to write all these things. We don't need to see what type of data we need to provide. So just wait for a moment, and that's amazing how to use abstract API in talib. So for this, open is data open comma data high, and then we need low and close. So data low, and then lastly data close. What else do we need? I think that's it. And then enter. If I check engulfing here, we can see that again, yeah, it's a series with a lot of zeros. And I'll have to check what are the actual points where it is showing an action, like it will be having a minus 100 or plus 100. Now before going to the abstract API, guys, I recently got an email from YouTube that a significant amount of people are not subscribing to my YouTube channel but watching my videos frequently. So please help me. Just one click, guys, just subscribe it. And then also like this video, it really helps with the algorithm. Now guys, you can see that for all different functions, there are different types of input data that we need to provide. For example, in Arun oscillator, we needed to provide the high and low data. For engulfing, we needed to provide open, high, low, close data, etc. So this is very annoying because we cannot use multiple functions, because for different functions, we need to provide different type of data. So what is the solution? The solution is abstract API that I was talking about. So what we need to do here is import talib, or I would say from talib import abstract. Now this abstract API has all the technical indicators which are available in the function API. The only difference is that the input is always the same. Let me tell you how to do it. Let me run this cell again, which is this one, and then we have the data. Let me just write data is equal to this. If we write write abstract API, like we write abstract dot, and then you can see that all the functions which are available for talib are available for the abstract API as well. So let me take the Arun oscillator, and you can see that inside this we just need to provide a pandas data frame or dictionary or numpy arrays, where we should have these things: open, high, low, close and volume. That's it. You can see that there's no adjusted close here. We have close here, and also all the column names should be in the lowercase, like high is in lowercase, low is in lowercase, close is in lowercase. But in this case, we have each and everything in higher in uppercase. So we'll have to convert all these columns to lowercase, and then we'll use the abstract API, which can be done like this. So here I have renamed all the columns with open, like from open to lowercase open, from high to lowercase high, from low to lowercase low, from adjusted close to lowercase close, because I'm interested in adjusted close, right? From volume to lowercase volume. And if I run this cell, you can see that all the data is now available. I'm not interested in this column, this one, because this is closed. I'm interested in this one. Anyways, the abstract API will just consider this one, not this one. Perfect. So now let's see a rune abstract is equal to abstract dot rune oscillator. And then what I need to provide is data. That's it. Let me just write a rune abstract again. Let's see what is the output. Okay, so the spelling mistake. A rune abstract. It's very easy. So you can see that we have got the data, the series for a rune abstract. If it is something else, say dot b bands, or say let me take a candlestick doji, right? So candlestick doji, and then again just the data, this will have the output of this one. So what we need to do here is just provide data after changing the column names, and we can see that all these things can be taken out directly without considering what type of data you are providing in the formula. So now the big question: can we use this abstract API to make the trading board? Because in that case we won't be concerned about what type of data do we need to provide for different functions, but we can take, or I would say we can consider all the available technical indicators for our analysis. The answer is yes, definitely, and this is what I'm going to do in my next videos. We can make use of multiple technical indicators using this abstract API and just providing this data as input. I've made a very easy user-friendly code for you guys in order to have it as a starting point. So what you need to do here is just run this cell and then mention the technical indicators. This code will tell you all the types of indicators that can be used for your analysis. And then in this one, what this will do is, what you need to do here is just provide the ticker name. So for example, Tesla. And then after that, this will give you the data frame and some charts of Tesla and the type of technical indicators that is used here. In this case, it is RSI. I'll be saving this code and the above code as well that I made while recording this video in my Google Drive. And my already existing subscribers know how they can access my Google Drive. My new viewers, what you can do is subscribe to my YouTube channel and then click on access to my Google Drive, provide some basic details, and I'll be using this email address to give a free access of my Google Drive. And there are many more codes that are available on that Google Drive. It's everything is free for use. There is no copyright issue. In my future videos, I will work on some trading bots using this technical analysis library. And I'll be also using another library that is used for backtesting for TA-Lib library. So just subscribe to stay tuned. If you like my work, then you can support me on Patreon. On Patreon, you can see that for different levels, I provide different types of services. For example, in gold level, things like tip of the day, early access to codes, etc. And then on levels such as platinum level, things like access to my to the WhatsApp group, monthly Google Hangout, etc. For legend level, things like trading strategy of the month, premium fintech posts, code of the week, etc. For god level, these services. If not Patreon, you can also buy me a coffee by following the link which is mentioned in the description box, and just select 1, 2, or 5 coffees if you want to give me a tip for this particular video. Thank you so much for watching this video till the end. You can click here to subscribe to my YouTube channel, and over there are some recommended videos. Just see how I made my Bitcoin trading bot. Let me tell you again, it generated some excess return. So thank you so much. See you soon in my next video.